We are strive and a reach for the goal. Them a fight and a spite, you them in control. Them a real asshole. But a long time, we are fight for your slice of the bread. Them a scream and a dream and a wish we fi dead. But I got off we head. I know just now, we are scream and a chill for the team. Them a plan out fi bench, we and them rule supreme. Like a them one fi clean. Well imagine, we are try move out of the shock. Them a cry and a spy and a try stop we clock. Guess I who off we back. Tell them so we bless. Tell them we bless, tell them we bless, tell them we bless. Tell them we bless, tell them we bless, tell them we bless. Tell them so we still have life, we no stress. God light shine on we.
Once again, it is on. Yes indeed, checking in, checking in. We are here, we are here. This is your host, Ross Isis, and my main brethren.
Rebel with a cause.
And you already know, you are now tuning in to the Think Champs, no doubt. We in. Blessings and peace and love to all checking in. And we building the day, we going black, which I love, you know what I'm saying? This is the times we going black into our own culture, our own time, before the internet, or before we entered into a net. Because you know, once you get into the net, you are trapped.
You're trapped.
A web, too. You get caught up in a web, you're trapped, too. You know that.
World Wide Web.
All right. So we in a serious time where Google is not baby talk. You remember baby said, Google Gaga. Google Gaga.
Google,
you know, that was that was the original Google. You know, and now everybody touching Google all day. They don't even talk to humans like they talk to Google right now, right? So we in a time where we just want to take you black, you know what I'm saying, into the old school rule time, you know, when things was real and black people was really showing love, you know, when laws were stern.
And justice stood.
And people were behaving.
Like they all too good.
All right, good. So you already know the tile we building on, you know what I'm saying? When things was really real, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, real MCs, you know what I'm saying? Not using drugs, but actually selling them and making money off drugs. Yeah. Right now we got in the Bronx, in the boogie, right? So much heroin addicts in the Bronx, in the boogie, you know what I'm saying? Full of heroin right now, you know what I'm saying? And guess who's on it? Our people. You know what I mean? We got hooked on the heroin because they was doing all the opioids.
That's,
and then they
the
got
problem.
Hooked on the Percocets.
Yeah, there we go.
You know, and next thing you know, that's too weak for them and they need something a little stronger. So now they all heroin addicts. Yeah. This is what the America has made into us as a people, you know what I'm saying? Heroin addicts. Notice these things don't come from Africa, you know what I'm saying? It's not our history is all these drugs, you know what I mean? Our history is actually what? Fruits, herbs, and vegetables, you know what I mean? Living things from trees. That's what we ate and that's what we did, you know what I mean?
Natural,
but now
fresh.
You let man come and create all these little false things to weaken your mind, you know what I mean? Take you off your spiritual journey, you know, because that's all these things are. The alcohol, you know what I mean? It took a lot of our brothers out, you know what I'm saying? You know, you have alcohol on each and every corner in our neighborhoods, right?
Old design.
You know, then you got the drug dealers pushing the drugs that we don't even make. Now you got this time where black man is walking around on drugs with pistols on their hip. This is an ugly situation now. Because now you're not under the natural influence, you know what I mean? You're under a drug chemical influence, right?
The drug culture.
Right, so it become a drug culture. See what happened now? The youth now pick up the drugs and they picking up the guns. But see, they don't. One thing they don't realize is that every drug, whether it's a pharmaceutical pill or it's an aspirin, right? All of them create one thing: suicidal thoughts.
Yeah, that's a fact.
Psychotropics. Every medication that these people give you will create suicidal thoughts. That's why you see so much suicide and uncalled for crimes. You know what I mean? Here these youth broke up into the CVS, the pharmacy. They didn't go for the bank. They didn't go for the money.
Oh, yeah. They went for the pills.
How are we in a time where we robbing drug stores? Okay, this is what's going on. Fiends, we becoming fiends in this day and time. But again, we're gonna take you back to how black people really lived in the original times. You know what I'm saying? Before we were hooked on these people drugs, because you got to think, and this is the think champs. There was a time and a great period when we wasn't on no man's pharmaceutical drugs.
Nah.
All our medicine came from the earth. Okay. The water is two, if it's just the water, yeah. With the fruit in it is going to be four.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, we in it, and this is what it's all about. We building. So, Red, build with him for a minute, King. You know I'm here. I need to light a switch. It's
going to
be a deep conversation.
Yeah, yeah. Where we going to go from here? The opioids in Middle America.
Mm-hmm.
The heroin in the Bronx.
Mm-hmm.
The new weed.
Ooh.
Let's not forget about the heroinic marijuana. Mm-hmm. That loud. It's monster weed.
Right.
So they creating all the strands.
Mm-hmm.
Any way they want. They're mixing unnatural patterns.
That's so true.
They kind of doing what they want.
When does weed start giving you a headache? Like, how does that work?
You know they call Reggie block work. The youngins.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
We still on that block work.
Mm.
But the drug, you know they want us all on drugs.
True.
White people been taking psychotropic drugs.
Always.
So, you know, about 70%. That's what they say. Got that medicine cabinet and really need what they be taking, Thorazine, Ambien,
Oxys,
they got niggas, Xanax, Perks.
There's so many.
Now, when we was coming up, where those pills were?
Right.
In white boys' pockets, no, not even trying to diss them. White boys would have the uppers and the downers. It was some brothers doing it in the 70s and all that. You know, you'll find us doing uppers and downers.
And it's getting caught out there.
Yeah, but
it was trending.
Not really no real white drug. Remember the rule, no white drugs?
Mm-hmm.
So we not really can't do no crack, coke, pills, heroin. You know what I mean? But they push it so hard, the music. So now the Molly has become peace. The Molly has become like a staple. You see how this is your staple? Because we had Molly, Wu-Tang, a million brothers understanding what marijuana is and bringing some sort of connection to it.
True.
Even Bill and Ted, Excellent Adventure, they was high too.
Yes,
but point, man, we went from natural, that's why it was so illegal.
Mm-hmm.
They put it next to crack.
Because
what we get to do now, now they selling the weed.
That's true.
So weed illegal when we sell it.
Yeah.
And legal when they want to, you know, stand on the corner.
Yeah, when they get a hold of it. Yeah.
So what we dealing with is a society that's going down. And they reaching. So they need marijuana now. That's why they trying to take it off the law books and clear.
Capitalize on it.
Yeah. And we need to capitalize. A lot of our brothers and sisters are doing it, but back to the point. The world we in today, my people, you need the old school laws. It sounds funny, right? That you could Google something real quick, and if I rep the old school law, right, I'd have to wait till tomorrow, go to the library, and then get the book, read it, and then, so you'll have your report like a day or two before me, right?
Mm-hmm.
But when we go to the class and demonstrate in front of the class our report, we probably would get a higher grade using the old basic method of learning. Quick learning is you could get overthink. Their mind is crowded. It's like watching TV and keep going, right? All of those pictures in your mind. You don't know what to watch. You confused, but you don't feel confused, but your mind is. So it's information overload.
That's true, too.
Go on your Instagram. Swipe. Count. How many worlds you in?
That's for one swipe.
It's a lot of energy on the internet also. We gotta get back to metaphysics too. Or spirituality in its real sense. I don't like what I see. The fake spirituality shit today, but you know, having a true sense of balance to know the ingredients of what's right and what's wrong. So you could really have an understanding when you say no or yes to something. You don't just follow the crowd. Or that's the new thing? Because, look, when I first saw Instagram, I saw the word say followers. First thing out of my mouth, oh shit, they creating followers to follow followers. The science ain't make no sense. I don't want no followers. Right. In that sense, we would love for the world to follow Think Champs. You feel me? But do you want followers? I want leaders to follow me so they won't be following me. We walk side to side. So you're not following me, you with me.
True.
So I never liked that word. So they creating that, you follow?
Right.
You follow, so you're the low point. You're the follower.
Right.
Nah, it should say leader and leaders, those are the other leaders. But it's just the science they keep pushing on us where we kind of lose reverence for intelligence or deep understanding. That's why they running with Biden. No real understanding in the political scheme of where he come from, how many years, who was he associated with. For him to say, yo, you gotta vote for me because you black. I'm your man. You supposed to know, no you're not.
Right.
If he wasn't. Or you supposed to know, yeah you are. But they don't know, they got the Obama. They got the Obama psychosis.
Whiplash, brainwash, yeah, man.
It's a personality, right? And they don't care about your politics. So, what you get? Alright, I vote for Ross, and I don't care what he doing, I like Ross. Now Ross don't gotta do nothing for me. That's why he was talking to him on that secret tape like that.
Exactly.
In a more stern, bully.
Yeah.
That was like a bully. We don't consider bullies, but.
So then we gotta run something off the tape. You know?
Yeah.
Yeah, we just might as well run something off the tape so y'all could actually hear the words that this man is speaking, you know?
Yeah, we gonna play that for y'all, the little clip. Let's go to it right now.
For real.
I'm the first person, black or white, who called attention to the fact that you were finding that there was the rate of people who are African Americans are dying is three times that of white people. I don't carry around a stamp on my head saying progressive and I'm AOC. But I have more of a record of getting things done in the United States Congress than anybody you know. Anybody you know. By 2040, this country is going to be minority white European. Hear me? Minority white European. And you guys are going to have to start working more with Hispanics, who make up a larger portion of the population than you all do. Let's get something straight. You shouldn't be disappointed. What I've done so far is more than anybody else has done this far. Okay? Number one. Number two, I mean what I say when I say it.
We don't care about throwing fists in the air and the symbols. We want the substance. The Joe Biden I know is substance. The Kamala Harris I know is substance. We need it now more than ever. And I would hope that the first day you start doing the things with your executive orders to restore some dignity to law enforcement in our community and the voting.
There's some things that I'm going to be able to do by executive order. I'm not going to hesitate to do it. But what I'm not going to do is I'm not going to do what used to, Benita, you probably used to get angry with me during the debates when you'd have some of the people you were supporting that on day one, I'm going to executive order to do this. Not within the constitutional authority. I am not going to violate the Constitution. There is a Constitution. It's our only hope. Our only hope. And the way to deal with it is where I have executive authority, I will use it to undo every single damn thing this guy has done by executive authority. But I'm not going to exercise executive authority where it's questioned, where I can come along and say, I can do away with assault weapons. There's no executive authority to do away with that. And no one's fought harder to get rid of assault weapons than me. Me. But you can't do it by executive order. You do that, next guy comes along and says, well, guess what? By executive order, I guess everybody can own machine guns again.
Yeah. Told you that shit was crazy, right? You see how he's talking to him?
You see that? I'm loving it because it's what they sign up for. Excuse him, Watt. It's not the corona.
That's that block.
It's the natural ganja.
That's that block.
Yeah, word. Yeah. Y'all forgot that make you cough too, really. But definitely, though, you see what the man is going into. You know what I mean? See the mindset he into. This is a slave master mindset. You know, you are slaves. You should know your position and stay in your position. That's what he's really telling you, you know, in a nutshell, in cold, you know. And these are times we in because no one really respects the field Negro anymore.
Nope.
No one respects the field Negro. The whole society is accepted house Negro mind state, you know, and that's what we in. We in the house Negro mind state. The field Negro know that he wasn't going to go vote for Master. After all Master done did to him, his intentions was never to vote. He never felt that somebody needed to die for his vote. That was never the real field Negro's mindset, yeah. You know, because he was too intelligent to do so. You know, we forget that, you know. And this whole thing with Biden, you know what I'm saying, it's going to bite y'all for real, you know. It's going to bite y'all because, yeah, it's going to bite you because you picked up the snake. You picked the snake up and you held him and you voted for him. You did all you did for the snake. So when it bites you, you're going to know it was a snake for real. This is what the biting going to do. It's going to bite you, you know, because we now sealing up this year, you know, as the worst Christmas for a lot of people, you know, who's still celebrating Christmas. It's going to be the worst Christmas under their tree, you know.
You mean by presence or spirit?
I'm saying just year in general because the money ain't rolling, you know what I'm saying? And times is hard, ever than it ever have been, you know what I'm saying, for the people who's not working, you know what I'm saying, not hustling, not doing anything, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
So they waiting on the stimulus, right, to actually come through the mail as if it's a Christmas gift or a bonus check, right? But these things are going to be a fleeting illusion. This is what's going to happen because it's not going to manifest. It's not going to happen.
There's another check coming?
No, no check. Well, the thing is, they dangle a check up like a mistletoe. They dangle a check up for you, you know what I'm saying?
Biden or Trump?
It's both of them. But not even Trump,
Biden,
I wouldn't say.
Got a check for people?
No, Trump done cut his last check. He done fought his last fight for America because he said they ain't vote for him. They ain't really care for the things he was doing for them. They rather bite and bite him. So,
yeah.
This is what's going to happen. It's going to be the bite. The bite and bite.
The bite is they helped him win, right?
Mm-hmm.
And now they not going to get nothing for it. They almost getting scolded for it.
Yeah.
It's like, aye, 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 aye. Mm-hmm. Look how he talked to them. That was the NAACP.
Mm-hmm.
What? We know what it is, mm-hmm. but for the world's sake, that's supposed to be the one of the top black representative groups
mm-hmm.
with mad power.
So-called, yeah.
You know, right under the Democrat power, they'll give them a little power so they can sway certain blacks to do certain things.
Yeah.
Okay, that's what I meant by power. Point. Look at how they talk to them. You was right when you said master.
Yeah, that's all it is. It's a slave master mentality. And they comfortable being in the house nigga's house. You know? And they all looking to get in there.
Biden a real master, too.
Oh, my gosh.
He from the cloth.
But here's the thing, though. How can any human being, right, flesh and blood, that's born as from a mother and a father, right, say out their mouth that there's too many people on the planet? Francis, you don't own the planet. No human being, one person, owns the planet, but how could you...
He might want to differ with you with that.
As a human being, amongst other humans, can come out your mouth and say there's too many people on the planet. That's a wicked mind state, you know.
It's a great step for man, even greater step for mankind.
Mm. Mm.
Don't tell me he didn't tell you.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Maybe he's a kind of a man. You want him to act human, but maybe he can't.
So there's two types of men. You got the created man,
mm-hmm.
and you got the made man.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you got the made man, because there were children on the earth that was created in the image and likeness of the creator.
By the earth.
Right. No. Well, by the creator himself.
Well,
he created them in his image and likeness, and yes. He created male and female. He created them. He said unto them, be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth and subdue it.
Yes, sir.
So when this was being done, this was way before man was made.
Yes.
Man was made specifically in the garden. You understand, from the dust of the garden, you know what I mean, and formed the man, yeah. which was the man called Adam.
The dust is the dirt, right?
Right. But that wasn't the original man.
Okay.
That was the created man. I mean, the made man. So it was a different gene already coming in the earth now. You see what I'm saying? Because now the one who he said, be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth, had the whole earth. But Adam never had the earth. Adam never had the earth. Adam had a garden. He had the east side of the garden. That's like being in East Atlanta. I can't come to the west side. You know, I can't even go out the city because I'm just on the east of Eden. So that's all he was there. That was his specific place. He couldn't leave there neither. So when we're talking about the real dominion of the true chosen people, they travel freely with the creator as one. You know, and this is the original man. You know, this is I and I from the beginning, male, female, children on the earth, you know. We were being fruitful and multiplying, replenishing the earth. You know, it was ours. Why? Because the Creator created it for us, and He created us to enjoy it. This is the original people. So now, you got times where Adam and Eve go to their stages, but how could they be the only people on the earth when a man come true by the name of Satan? They tried to tell you he was a serpent. But it was a man physically came through. Right?
It's a metaphor, allegory.
And tempt Eve. Distracted her from a natural path, because they still was on a natural path, because in the day they didn't wear clothes.
Yeah.
And it was butt naked. Butt nature. Right?
Yeah, there we go.
In creation. Right?
Fire.
Naturally. So it wasn't until Eve actually met with the serpent, which is the devil. You understand, he was walking the earth because he can't reach the heavens. He's only on the earth. He's only on the earth. So the only way the devil can reach you is mentally, you know. That's why you have to raise your vibration higher into the heavens. because the heavens is a state of mind. You sitting out there waiting to die to go to heaven. How foolish are you?
You win.
How foolish are you? Every day you living in hell then, if you waiting to die to go to heaven.
Most people are mentally not sick, but castrated.
Mm-hmm.
So they're miserable.
Mm-hmm.
When you can't solve a problem, those minutes is what I'm considering misery. So if you really have no understanding, you're in that misery spot.
True.
A lot longer than people recognize.
True.
Or like to admit.
Right. Because hell is a mind state. So is the devil a mind state. You know, the devil is error.
Yeah.
The devil is error. So the devil didn't make you do it. You did it. You did it. It's the devil, and you know it's you inside of you doing it.
Can the devil inspire you, though?
Oh, yes, definitely. That's what he do. Inspire you to do what's wrong, and you fall. Because that's the...
for your own mood.
Right. The error, again. Comfortable creating errors, that's what the devil do. You know what I'm saying? He always saying something. That's why he's Satan. He always have something to say. You know, he can't be quiet.
You gotta block him.
So there's a whole energy there that when you can't be still and be quiet in yourself. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes you have to be quiet. It's good to listen. Listen to yourself. People say they don't smoke weed. I said, why you don't smoke weed? Oh, it make me think too much. What's wrong with thinking?
Weed.
What's wrong with thinking? I mean, who told you that you shouldn't be thinking too much? You know what I mean?
Weed is knowledge because it makes me think.
Mm.
Keith Murray, baby.
Mm-hmm.
Come on.
Exact. So we in the era where people don't like to think anymore. People just want to hear what someone says and agree with it. Because I feel what you're saying.
I hate I feel. No. I think.
Okay.
You hear how everybody say I feel?
Uh-uh.
We got to erase that. People, I feel. Mm-hmm. Yo, Ross, you gonna get the new store? Yo, I feel you're gonna do it, Ross. No, I think you're gonna do it.
Right.
It's a thought, not a feeling.
All right.
So let's kill I feel for I think.
Mm-hmm.
My bad.
Nah, it's real. So black to the story at hand, even the garden, most I tell us, say, look, don't mess with that tree over there. That tree right there is a tree of knowledge, right? And if you eat from that tree, your eyes will be open, right? And you'll be susceptible to the worldly things of the world because you left the higher state. Because you're already in the heavens, you know. You're already in the heavens because you're in heaven, which is a mind state, right?
Bliss.
But you can lose your heavens if you get tempted by this serpent, which is this devil, you understand? Which is going to come with his distractions, right? So she in the garden. She never ate from the tree because she knew what it was. And Mosiah said, don't eat it. I'm not going to eat it. But here comes a man walk through the garden and say, you know what? That's a nice tree you and Bungo Adam got over there. That's a nice tree, you know. Yeah. It was bearing fruit like that. You mind if I get one of the fruit? Oh, no. You can't eat that fruit. I can't eat the fruit. Who told you I can't eat the fruit? Give me this. Let me eat this fruit here. This fruit is good. It's delicious. And you mean you can't eat this delicious fruit? You don't even want to try it? You mean y'all got this nice tree in the yard and nobody eating from it? You're not supposed to eat from the tree. I just ate it. Ain't nothing happened to me.
Yeah.
Ain't nothing happened to me. I'm right here. Come on, try this fruit.
It's good for you.
That's the story they want you to see. I'm going to show you the real story. Real story is that she was buck natured. She was naked, unclothed. He walking through the garden, seeing her unclothed, and knowing that she never even been with man before. Mm. Right? Imagine that.
Virgin.
Right, you in the land here, y'all don't even know anything about sex, anything, you know, at all. Cause y'all still in the garden, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So he tempted Eve through sex, right? Tempted her through sex, which she had and did. Through that act, she went to Bungo Adam. and had a sexual act with Bungo Adam. So now they both having a sexual act together, which he never had, but she brought it on because she learned it from the other man in the garden, right? So now they have the sexual intercourse. The Most High come walking through the garden now. Here come the Father. Now, being the Father, you know your children is naked because they don't know much. You know what I'm saying? That means basically an open mind. You free from all sins because you're naked. You know what I'm saying? Your thoughts are free, yeah. Right? So now, he walks through the garden, and he calling for Adam, and he calling for Eve, but they run and go hide. This is where you see how the story get real. Because now, why would you run and go hide from your father if you didn't do anything?
Yeah.
So it was a form of guilt. But then when you do return to the father, what did they come with? They said they came with figs and olive branch leaves tied around their waist. So they were covering their nakedness. Ah, so you forget this part. You forget the part that they had to cover their nakedness now. But all before that, they wasn't covered. They were free running through there and everything was good. Now, you're running through and you're covering yourself like you did something, you know. So, the act was known, so the Most High knew what happened. He told Adam, he said, what happened? He said, I don't know, you know, she did it. He always, you know, the man blamed the woman immediately. She did it, she came, did something, and now I'm doing this. I didn't even know what it was about. But he still had a mind of his own. You know what I'm saying? He could have said, I'm not doing that. I ain't none of that. You know what I mean? The act took place. So the Most High banished him. You understand? Out of the garden, right? Into hard labor. You know, they was the first people to actually till the earth, you know. Adam and Eve was the first ones to till the earth for food. Anyone else, like I said, the Most High's children were being fruitful and multiplying. And he said, I put everything on the earth for you to eat. Every fruit that beareth seed, every herb that beareth seed, it be, shall be for you for meat. So we were already living off the natural things of the earth already. You know what I mean? Then this man come, go against the word of the Most High. In order to get his food, he had to till the soil. You understand? And a straight darkness they dealt with. They didn't get no sunlight anymore. It was darkness they was cast into. So you tilled in soil and trying to bring food out of some wintry place is going to be a hard, hard, hard life, you know? So Adam and Eve left the garden. Eve bears a son, right? The first son she had was Canaan. That was not Adam's seed, right? That was not Adam's seed. Canaan was not Adam's seed. She bore another child, which was Abel. Abel was actually Adam's birth child, his first child, right? One woman, two wombs. I mean, one womb, two children, right? But they're brothers. But they grow up and now totally different. Abel is into gardening. Abel is into the land, you know what I'm saying? He's a herbalist, you know what I mean? He's a vegetarian. He don't kill any animals, nothing like that. The other hand, Canaan is killing. He's a hunter. He out there is killing and cutting up every type of flesh he could get a hold of, you know what I'm saying? So he was on a different vibe. Already they were two totally different men, you understand? Two totally different fathers.
Two different natures.
Two different, everything totally different. Totally different souls, because one coming from Satan and the other coming from Adam, which was the Almighty's child. So then they now get into an age now whereas they get into a conflict, and Abel got killed by his brother Canaan, right? Cain killed Abel. Now, when Cain killed Abel, that was the first human blood shed on the earth. The earth never, no one ever died on the earth. You understand? The first murder, that was Cain, he was the first murderer. So this man here killed him, and the Most High heard the cry of the blood from the earth. When the blood spilled and touched the earth, the Almighty heard the cry of the blood and came immediately. Aili Selassie, came immediately on to Canaan and asked him, what happened to your brother? What did you do to your brother? What was Canaan's response that these people still say to this day? Canaan said, "Am I my brother's keeper?" This is what Cain said.
Oh, I didn't know that was my question. Am I my brother's keeper?
So
that's what he said.
Here's the question. Am I my brother's keeper and we have two different fathers?
So is that like a more deeper lesson? I'm still on it, but that means if we don't have the same father, then another race would be my brother.
Mm-hmm.
So do I gotta watch for other races too?
Right.
Do I gotta be a humanitarian?
True.
Or just watch for myself?
Right. But see, it was cursed. It was a curse that Cain had got from doing these things.
Oh, yes, sir.
Right? So the curse went on to Canaan, right? Or Cain. He got cursed and he got cast out. So when he got cast out, he got cast into the Caucasus Mountains. But not only that, he got cursed with leprosy. So we forget these things, you know what I'm saying? But we need to go black and know these things because it's still a true story.
What's leprosy?
Now, leprosy would be the pigmentation of the skin totally becoming white.
A loss of melanin.
Totally.
So God stripped his melanin.
Right. That was a curse because everyone on the earth was melanated people. So to identify you were cursed with the leprosy, so your skin was turned so everyone would know you have that curse. You know?
So really cursed.
True sign. So way go, and what happened afterwards goes into the era that we are living in now, where is that the same type of fight is going on again against the Most High's children, because remember, they come through the same womb.
Yeah.
You understand? But live a totally different lifestyle. One's a cannibalist and one's a herbalist.
That's a good way.
You know, one's here to kill and one's here to heal.
Bars.
I'm saying, so that's where we at, you know what I mean, in the same time now, because if you flip it into this century we living in now, you got the cannibalist trying to tell the herbalist what they should do to live.
Yeah.
But the herbalist know that the cannibalist shouldn't be leading nobody, okay? The real herbalist, we know that the cannibalist shouldn't be leading no one because they all sick. You understand? They eat in sickness. You know what I mean? The flesh causes mucus in the body. You understand? Which builds up for all these flus and symptoms people having is because you're packed up with all these animals. You understand? And all these fleshly products that these people creating.
Yeah.
But if you want to really live, and only people that's going to live is people who return into a natural state of eating. It's just a reality, you know? So when we go into the scriptures and things like that, I want to show you how black it is, because sometimes y'all think the scriptures is some white people thing. Y'all forget that we wrote languages. We were the ones who taught every language on this planet. No one didn't create no language but us. We still creating the Ebonics over here.
Still.
Yeah.
Deciphering anything.
Anything, anyhow.
It's
so,
really sound, right?
True.
We sound beings. We can pick up vibration.
True.
That's why we can flip more than everybody else.
Mm-hmm.
So you're blessed with the language.
Right.
Being able, how many languages in Africa?
Well, it's a lot. Languages.
My point.
Yeah, languages in total, I'm thinking.
We don't speak the most languages?
Anywhere between 40 to 80,000 languages. Easy.
Africa speak the most languages, right?
Totally. Every African speaks at least 7 languages.
The most vibrational.
Easy, that's just a few. Most of them speak more than that, but at least 7 languages the Africans speak. And to be able to comprehend other languages is a form of intellect,
is
an intelligence.
Yes,
you know, you over here speaking Ebonics and all you saying is bruh and profanity out your mouth, that's no intellect, that's no intelligence in that. You know, this is not the original state of our people. To be able to speak more than one language is very, very intelligent. Like I had a youth that came through the shop, you know, a friend of my son, he was locked up for 2 years, right? And locked up in the system for 2 years, he went in 19, he came out 21. And The 2 years he was in jail, he didn't go to prison because he didn't bow. He fought his case. You know what I'm saying? It's like a lot of us don't do. We just go whatever the judge and the lawyer say, we run with it. You know what I mean? Cool. But to actually fight his case, he was studying in there. His cellmate was a dude studying the Morris
science,
right? And he was helping him with law. So he took him to the federal laws, you know what I'm saying, which oversees the state laws, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And he wound up fighting his case so brilliantly as a young man, the judge wound up helping him beat and stay on his case and get out of there. The youth was about to do some major time, but he knew he didn't do it. He did nothing wrong, and he was in the right. He knew his rights. He stood up for it, beat the case, and came home in 2 years. But here's the fullness though. He come home in 2 years. He come in the shop, and my son building. I promise you, every 4 minutes in the conversation, you would hear the Almighty God name mentioned out this youth mouth at least 20 times. Mm. At least 20 times. It's in 4 minutes times, right?
Okay.
So he was on the Almighty. He was on God, right? I reasoned with him. I had to pull him aside, Bill with him a minute, you know, see where his head at. You know, he'd been through a little time. What's your plan? What you gonna do, black man? You know, the youth showed me that while he was in there, he learned to speak 3 languages. He finished school, got a degree, in the 2 years he was in there, right? Mm-hmm. Now, he fluently speaks Spanish, fluently speaks Arabic, right?
Nice.
And English and Spanish. I mean, what's the other one? Arabic, French, and Spanish, right? Of course, he do English, so it might be, I think he counted English too. So 3 languages the man's speaking, right? As a young man, mind strong, able to stay focused. He ain't on no drugs. You know what I'm saying? Not on any drugs, so his mind is powerful and strong right now. I told a black man, keep the pen in your hand.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, man, keep the book in your pocket.
Yes, sir.
You know what I mean? Because you're thinking.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You can go far like this if you stay on this meditation you on right now.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You get caught in these streets, hanging with these silly rappers, listening to these people. Next thing you know, want to try these silly drugs. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, you know, he get out, he realized, yeah, he need to stay on his path. He said he hung out with a couple of his friends his first night, but he realized a lot of that wasn't for him, and he chilled on that.
Okay.
See what I'm saying? So he knew if he go down that road, what is gonna happen. See, people forget that when black men get locked up and do some bids, we actually get time to sit down and think.
That's the positive negative.
Mm-hmm. We actually get time to sit down and read. You know, read. Yes, because black people in prisons and jails is reading. They read in full books in less than days and less than weeks. Full books is getting read and shared and passed on. Knowledge is being passed cell to cell.
Understanding.
Right. And understanding. It's true. And then on top of that, they working out. You know what I'm saying? They ain't got no big health issues because they ain't out doing nothing crazy. You understand? Yeah. They getting 3 hots in the cot. You understand? 3 hots meaning hot meals and a cot to lay on. 3 hots in the cot. Anybody been locked up know what I'm talking about. So they got their 3 hots in the cot, you know what I mean? And going through their time, but after the time passed, you get to see what the black man build. Yeah, blessed love, blessed love. You get to see what the black man build, you know what I mean? How things really rose up from one level to the next, from just staying focused. Now, some of the strongest black men I know has been locked away in prison. In jail.
Most.
The strongest black man I know has been locked down in prison. Let's go down the line. Marcus Garvey locked up. He did 4 years here in the Georgia State Penitentiary, mm-hmm. right? Mandela locked up. He did what, 27 years to the door? You know they locked King up several times. You know, what's the brother just passed the other day? Good Trouble. John Lewis.
Oh, yeah.
Right, just put him in there because still in all, he's a black man behind bars. Let's just go real with that. Right. You feel me? And he stood for something, you know what I mean? So let's put him in there. But let's stay focused again. Malcolm X.
Locked.
Dirty Red.
Well, Dirty Red got locked.
Dirty Red, but he came out, Malcolm X. He went in there, learned to read the dictionary from beginning to end. That's what he did. He learned the dictionary from beginning to end. Right? In prison, in jail. Because he had the time. You know what I'm saying? No distractions. You know what I mean? He got his whole oneness and his strength up. Because this is what happened. You know what I'm saying? We don't get that time to think on these streets. Why? Because we're chasing the dollar. You know what I mean?
Dream.
We chasing the dream. We out here trying to survive. Right?
Pick that one up.
So,
the dream.
Yeah. So the end of the day is, the strongest black men and women we really got is still locked down in prisons. Believe it or not. You understand? Let's say Mutulu. Mutulu Shakur. It's a black man. He locked down.
Mumia,
very strong black man from a youth, been locked down. So what the whole message is that the strong-minded black men and women, they don't want free, because that is what's going to uplift us as a people. They want the weak ones out here, the ones who goes along just to go along. Right. And we got a lot of them on the planet out here doing their thing right now. You know what I'm saying? Posing as us.
Most.
You know what I mean? So let's stay focused. Let's go back to when things was real. You know what I'm saying? When we really worked together. You know what I mean? There was a thing called the hookup. Remember the hookup? Oh, man. Bless up, man.
Peace
and bless. Yeah, the hookup was a thing where is that whatever you needed, I had someone I could hook you up to get that done with.
Are we back in the... We going black? Yeah, confusion?
We got to go black.
Okay, we in 75 right now.
Yes, indeed.
Okay, the hookup, I get you.
So we was hooking each other up. Yo, I need a hookup with this.
Yo, my son playing baseball. You know somebody with a metal bat?
I got you. My man, I could hook you up with, got the metal bats, and he got the balls on discount that come with the bat.
Good looking, B.
I got you.
I need that.
You see what I'm saying?
He real. Because we was doing that without, like, documentation.
Mm-hmm.
It came with the game. It was more love back then. So.
What about this one? Man, I'm out here, man. I got to get some money. I could hook you up with a job.
There was a time.
I could hook you up with a job. What you do?
Yeah.
Can you do this? I'm going to hook you up.
Paint.
Call his number here and told him that I'm hooking you up. I'm hooking you up. They're gonna let you in there. You good?
There was a time we had jobs.
Ooh.
Available for that hookup.
Mm-hmm.
I was young, but I remember that. My pops and uncles got a lot of jobs like that.
Yeah, because it's really about who you knew. You know what I'm saying? Even here in Atlanta right now. To really get a job here, you got to know somebody.
In the world.
Yeah, you can't just be here just saying, I got all the credentials, I'm going to go up and get this job. It don't work like that. Georgia's a place like who you know.
You still got to know somebody.
That they can hook you up to get up in here. Otherwise, you ain't up in here. Everybody in there got hooked up. You wonder why they working. They got to hook up. Somebody hooked them up. They somebody family. But my point is saying, again, we have more unity. You know what I mean? Just from us working together, networking one another. What you need done? I got you. That was the realest thing we could ever say out of our mouth, is I got you.
That's before the internet.
Before the internet, yeah. Because right now, Google that. You know what I'm saying? Just whoever pop on the screen, go spend your money with them. You know what I'm saying? But your man's over there, who you could be supporting. You walk right by him, because you ain't took time, you know what I'm saying, to see what your people doing. You worry about what Google say.
He not on Google.
Right. Oh, he must not be that good. Because he ain't doing too good. He ain't on Google. You know what I'm saying? Big up to the Georgette You know, coming through with the natural well water.
Definitely.
With natural herbs and things in it too to keep us strong, you know what I mean? Meditation. So we drinking G2O water right now, you know?
Got that sweet and sour.
Yeah. Mm. Basil, mint, and some rosemary. Yeah. Herbs, you know?
Big up to her.
Yeah. No question. Big up to all the people still smoking real herb out there, man. Y'all,
clockwork.
Y'all greatest, man. Y'all the greatest out there, for real, for real.
Clockwork.
Because end of the day is that's what it's gonna be.
Yep.
By the end of the day, they're gonna be looking for that stuff and they ain't gonna be able to find it because it don't come with seed. You know what I mean? So how they gonna grow it again? You know what I mean?
It's the monster marijuana.
that thing is killing people. I hear people out there getting major migraines now from just smoking marijuana.
That's just like heroin.
Too much chemicals.
Yeah.
Too much chemicals.
You could even see a fiend pattern.
Oh, yes, definitely.
Come on, we smoke Reggie, right? That's what they call it.
Okay.
Right? Regular marijuana.
Right.
Never got nobody jumping through no window or throwing no real fit.
True. Never.
Loud, got these dudes.
Flipping.
It's almost looking like crack.
Right.
It's not crack, but I'm talking about the want and the need.
Even what about the attitude?
And the attitude comes.
What about the attitude the weed is called? How you smoke all this expensive weed and got attitude?
Yeah, you supposed to be high.
You supposed to be the happiest person over there. You done spent all your money smoking this expensive weed. You got the most attitude. You grumpy, you know, and you want to blow this smoke so people can smell it. You don't even share it.
And you say the name of it.
So, and people was to get hyped over the name. And that's the thing, too. Like, we don't need a name to be good weed. I'm about to tell you that. We never needed a name to be good weed. How weed was known, how it was good? From smoking it.
Yeah.
You had to smoke weed to know it was good. Be like, wait, man, that weed was smoking. Remember that?
Maybe the color.
That weed was good, man. That's some good weed. That was some good weed. That was
some blacks.
That was some good. This is some good weed. This is some good. You get this some good weed. What's this? Where you get this?
What's this?
Can I get some more of that? That's good weed.
Damn, son.
You ain't need to be pretty. You need to smell good. You ain't need to look pretty. You need to see a crystal on it. You need to roll it up and smoke it and say, okay, this is good weed. That's how you knew good weed with the meditation it gave you. You know, the vibration it gave you.
Yeah.
But when you're smoking all this expensive weed and you're still running around here with attitude, I'll show you something wrong with the weed. You don't know happy monster. They wake up angry. You smoke the weed, you make up angry. Natural herb, you smoke it, you'll be in a good mind state to get some things done. You ain't ready to go to sleep.
Nope.
You know what I mean? You ain't go ready to sit down. You ready to get up, get some things done. You know?
Like your man said, they don't smoke because they mind move. Then I said the Keith Murray line. Weed is knowledge because it makes me think. We invite that push of the mind.
Right.
We kind of, if you do it right, you can master the spin. You know, when you really first get high, right?
No doubt.
You be really high. You be like, oh, shit, I'm high. Or you be chilling, but you be in another zone. You smoke every second of your life. So do I.
Truth to rest.
So we stay in that.
True. Right, stay in that lock.
We stay in that, right?
And
I don't want to say we're successful, like we boast and we don't do that, but we, both of us have done some big things, right?
No doubt.
So us two as the
accomplishing
example.
Accomplishing things, yeah.
Accomplish some things, right? So there's somebody flying a plane right now, smoke that's hit crack right before the plane went off.
That's true.
Because he mastered smoking crack.
No doubt.
There's a pilot who's high off crack, but he's skilling that shit.
Right now.
So there is levels. I tell young people don't smoke till you get a brain. Till you really get a sermon of what you want to do. Don't even smoke.
Right.
Because they don't really got the plus degrees, right? So if it's just like a regular kid, don't even go into that world.
That's true.
Because come on, you can smoke whenever.
whenever. Exactly.
Get that ill job. I'm being a little facetious from where we angle from, but
no doubt.
Go get the real job. Mm-hmm, then mm-hmm. when you see him pretty, mm-hmm. light up.
Right, right.
Oh. Don't let lighting up get in the way. Because today
true.
Is not real weed.
Right.
It's like a drug.
True, true, true. Well, well, they make it a drug. You got a thing you got to take called a drug test. The drug test got you testing for weed.
But is that the white man game, or is it really a drug?
I think it has to be the game to make sure you're not smoking weed. You can do drugs, but you can't do weed.
But today's weed, if we put it under a lab light, mm-hmm. it might truly be considered a drug. It's not the most high marijuana.
Right, right. Truth and rights.
That's some monster marijuana they made in the lab.
Truth and rights.
So what else they put in it?
That's true. Bunch of chemicals. Everything is a chemical. The flavor's a chemical.
And it's for
the
color's
a chemical. The growth of it is a chemical.
It's probably in the mind.
Yeah, everything on the plant is a chemical to make it grow so. And the thing with them too is that, you know, they don't take time to water the plant for at least a month or so to drain all the chemicals and stuff out the plant. They literally just chop it down immediately and start, you know, curing it so they can sell it with all the chemical crystals still up on the thing. So people smoke the chemicals and think they really got something.
Yeah, so but, it's the chemical that make them high?
Oh man, it's definitely the chemical. I mean, because it's the flavor. Wow. All the flavor they in, you know, and it's bad because see how we had an incense lit? You can't smell the herb. You smell the incense. But when you're smoking that silly weed, the incense is the weed.
Yeah.
You can't even smell the incense because the weed is so potent over the incense.
Yeah.
You understand?
You can't hide in the room with loud.
You can't go nowhere. The man pull up on you. He can smell it on you and smell it in there.
Reggie trap.
But not like that.
No, I'm saying in the regular world. Mm-hmm. Regular weed travels.
Oh, right? Yes, indeed. True, true.
Loud going through the door.
For real. Yeah, straight through.
Y'all straight getting through. Caught in hotels because y'all got the loud.
Mm-hmm.
Me and Ross would be in a hotel chilling with the towel under the door.
Right. No problem.
No problem.
For real.
And we still reach the high.
All I got to do is light an incense and the place right rosy again. You know what I mean? But after you light that loud in that hotel room, that thing in the sheets, it's in everything. It's in everything. It's in the pillowcase.
Excuse
me.
You
know?
But that's going back to the old school. We ain't really, like, if they made loud in the old school, mm-hmm. we might have considered it a drug.
Mm-hmm.
Just because we know they be kind of manipulating it.
True.
We probably wouldn't have touched it just because we knew the white man had that pattern into it.
Mm-hmm.
We were more natural, bring the weed out. We kind of ran from white drugs.
Mm-hmm.
So today's rock and roll logic is only black people really discerning what America really is.
True.
We've been blocking that connect this whole time. Mm-hmm. They have too.
Mm-hmm.
The internet, I don't know, it made niggas think they white.
Oh yeah, that's exactly what it did, for real.
Because I don't know where they get this game from.
For real. And it's sad though because if you really check it, the amount of things that we actually built just from thinking, you know what I mean? From our own mind, we didn't need none of these people technology, you know what I'm saying, to design all the things we done built and designed. We just used our brain, you know what I'm saying, and our natural skills. So they did a study on some children that was in high school. And it was four children, and it was the parents, the adults of the children, right? They took the children and the parents on a study, which told them that they were going to take away their cell phones for a whole week. You know? This 1 week, they were going to take the children's cell phone, and the parents agreed with it, right? So they took the children's cell phone for a week, right? And they recorded what happened through the days. So they said the first day they took the children's cell phone, they was having anxiety attacks, you know, because they wasn't able to tune in knowing what was going on. Their friends, were they getting any likes, you know what I'm saying? Or how many hits, how many followers they done picked up, you know? So it was really biting them, what their friends talking about. So second day, anxiety still was kicking in, but they realized they had to do something, you know. So third day come, the parents said the children came out their room and they were sitting at the dinner table, eating dinner and having conversation. It's about a fifth day, the children was in the yard playing basketball, taking out the garbage and doing chores. By the sixth day, it said the sixth day, the children were normal and behaving like children.
Yes, sir.
No attitude, no nothing, just conversation and back to normal living, just from taking the cell phone from the children from 1 week solid.
Re-engineering.
All right. So we're looking at the studies and see that the phone is doing no good for our children. It's a total distraction from them being able to be creative.
Yeah.
You understand? With their hands and using their brain instead of being programmed.
No imagination.
Right, because here's a difference between looking at a fire blaze and looking at a TV screen. One is going to help you go into yourself, and the other one is taking you out of yourself. It's a big difference.
But they sell it like the world need it.
Right.
You know, the reverse angle. Look how damaging it is, right?
Mm-hmm.
But look how they sell it.
True.
Like you need it. And look at the whole world, right?
Mm-hmm.
On their phone.
Right. And it's sad because the end of the day is now we lost touch and communication with one another because of the cell phones. Our eyes is getting worse, you know? These things is really happening on real time, you know. People are losing their eyesight because they're staring at this screen, reading the screen too long.
Yeah.
Nobody telling us it's not good for your eyes. They saying we got a new phone coming out. Get this one. It got a new feature. Get this one. You know.
Blue light. It won't hurt your eye.
Right. So you sitting there with this screen in your face 20 hours a day.
Probably more.
Well, I give them 4 hours of rest, man. But it's sad because even when they sleep, the cell phone's still beside them. So if it beep or ring, they got to get up out their sleep to answer. It's sad.
First thing they pick up.
20 hours becomes 24 for real because they never really off the phone.
They dream about it.
Right. Wake up to it. And here's the thing. You wake up with the phone in your hand. So now with the phone in your head, you automatically creating fear in you because you're seeing what their program is. The program already gonna create fear into you, something you don't like. You ain't supposed to get up not liking anything. You're supposed to get up loving things. You understand? Wake up in a loving energy other than what you don't like and what somebody else is doing. You just get up out your sleep and you're worried about what somebody else is doing. Is that really important? You understand? So really and truly, for us to really gain our real, real strong mind state again, we got to put down this so-called weapon of mass distraction, because that's what I call it. The cell phone is a weapon of mass distraction. And simply pick a book up. Put your face in a book, literally.
Where did the Bible say the mark of the beast would be?
In your hand and in your forehead.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Where these phones at?
In their hand, and they got it straight up on it, looking straight to their forehead.
I rest my case, Your Honor.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, the drone pattern of the game today with the internet, that's why I was trying to break down the followers.
Mm-hmm.
You said it, as soon as they wake up on the internet,
right.
Looking at what?
Right.
Somebody else. Remember back in the day, let's go back old school logic, right?
Mm-hmm.
If I look at another man's success for too long, I won't ever concede to my own.
True.
I'm going to end up just watching you.
Right.
I could be inspired by you. Once that happens, I should go.
Mm-hmm.
And try to create.
That's true.
Not stand here all day, tomorrow, the next day. I'm not talking about the science of today's checking in on people on the internet. I'm talking about the science of that logic in general.
I see that.
You should be too busy for the internet.
True.
If you don't got business, mm-hmm. Like if you make money off the internet, kind of you don't count.
Let's do the numbers then. Let's do the numbers. You know, we like got to do with numbers. Let's do the numbers. How many hours in a day?
24.
Can we roll out, put the 24 on the screen just in case someone lost the focus right quick? Because I say focus. How many hours in a day? 24.
Right.
Right? How many hours do you get online? Just answer this question for yourself. How many hours do you think you spend online per day out of a 24-hour day? Do the numbers, okay? What you say? You got what, 12? You're on for 12 hours, okay? What about you? 16? What you got, 18?
I got 24 in the back.
A 24 in the back, because you don't put his phone down?
Yeah.
All right, good, 24 for him. All right, good. Now, how many of them 24 hours did you get a check?
Or do some working towards a check.
No, seriously.
I'll give you props.
Even if you, I'm saying you touch the screen for 7 hours a day, right? That's a low number, right? 12 hours a day, right? Touch the phone 12 hours a day. You don't work nowhere 12 hours a day, right? They don't work 12 hours a day, right?
Yeah.
But you working on that phone 12 hours a day. Mm. You ain't get paid for them 12 hours, though. You get paid not 1 hour, right?
Okay.
But the same amount of time and energy you put into that cell phone making nothing, you could have put that same time into doing something physically for yourself. You see what I mean? To make money, to do something real. You understand? To manifest something, to make something a reality. You can do that within those times and hours of a day. But see, out here in all these streets of America with all this distraction, you know, and the weapon of mass distraction in your hand, you don't make money, you spend money. And you're comfortable making it to spend money, you know? How much money do you think that black people have spent in the strip club from the year 2000 to the year 2020? Astronomical numbers, right?
No one knows.
Astronomical, right? Because, you know, we spending more money in the strip club than we spending on anything right now. Because, you know, they buying the clothes, but they only buying the clothes that go to the strip club, right?
Yeah.
To throw the money up. So we in a time where is that people waste more money than making more money. You know what I mean? In the original times, black people invest their money by buying land. They ain't built no house on it. Or they did build a house on it. They might put a trail on it. But at the end of the day, they invest their money in the land. You know what I'm saying? So now after the land, what they do? You know what I'm saying? Build a house, have their family on it. The land is still there. They had something that values something, you know?
Yeah.
So we had a state where we knew that the land was more valuable than anything. Now we value the material things and not the land at all. You have a $500,000 house bricked up and you don't own the dirt to sit on. $500,000 house, but you don't own the dirt that the house sit on.
That's the science.
So you see the mind state? We're not thinking. We're not thinking at all. Because if we really thinking, we'd purchase the land and build on the land and we'll be free. You see what I'm saying? But we're not thinking like that. We get the land, we fight over it. You know what I mean? Family died, left you the land. It's 18 acres. What you fighting for? You know what I'm saying? End of the day is, you get 9 and the other family member get 9. There's no argument. There's no disagreement. Everybody good. No. This land belonged to me and they shouldn't get this land and whoop-de-whoop.
I need 15.
So now the land can't get occupied. Nothing's going on the land when it could have been actually doing something. We take for granted the amount of land on this planet. I want to pull up on the screen right quick the amount of acres that Africa has. Because see, this is the misunderstanding that they've been doing way too long. They literally took Africa and making us think Africa is a very small, small place. You understand? And other places on the map is much bigger. They never really want us to see the true size of Africa on the planet.
Yeah.
Period. You understand? So we did the math, we did the numbers, right? And the numbers come up real. I got 7.505 billion acres that Africa is on. Let's read it again. 7.505 billion acres of land. That's how big Africa is. That's how many acres in Africa. Billions, right? Let's go to America. How many acres in America, right? 3.797 million. That's how many acres in America. How many acres in North America? 9.54 million. Asia. You know they come with the foolishness, right? They come to say Asia is the biggest continent on the planet, right? Which I already knew was foolishness because Asia is not really a continent. It's split up and it's broken up and all kind of things, right? It ain't like you got one full land of Asia. You know what I'm saying? It's split up. It's broken up. But now you got the full land of Africa, which is a solid continent. And you want to tell me Asia bigger than that? So I knew that was foolishness, right? So we go to the math and do the numbers on how big Asia is. 17.21 million.
Wow.
17.21 million. Europe is only 3.931 million. That's all Europe is. Europe and America ain't too far apart. They ain't even reached 4 million people, 4 million acres.
Hell, you already know. Let's pull up the Africa with all the countries in it.
Yes, indeed.
Put that one up. Look how that look. The whole world could fit in Africa.
Ah, you see it there. Yes, indeed.
Most of the world. There's a few things missing, but most of the world could fit in Africa. 1 billion people in China.
Mm-hmm.
In Africa, that's just middle Africa, the tip to the south.
Uh-huh.
How many more billions could fit? So, you guys were blessed with the most purest land. You should control it.
Truth and right. And don't just listen to this information, research this information, because we need you to see this stuff for yourself right now, you know what I mean? Because we need to wake up and realize that we are the majority of this earth. You understand? The majority of the land is in Africa. How come the majority of people couldn't be all over the world? Let's stay focused. You are tuning in to a live episode again of The Think Champs. Peace and blessings, y'all.
Use your brain.
One love.